I dreamed of playing football!
But I was allergic to milk, and the soybean juice substitute that my mother gave me made my bones weak.
But I digress. My point is, I love football! Football! The ballet of bulldozers, the moments of grace in a sea of fury, the crowd fickle, fanatical, and faithful. Every kickoff is possibility, every down a war, and every now and then it doesn't come down to fancy strategy or speed or strength. It comes down to who has more heart. Yes, you see, football is in my bones. And where goes the two-point conversion, the onside kick, or the TV timeout? So go I! I've seen the locker rooms, my friends. I have smelled the shoes, stormed the field, and sung the songs. And I have heard the footsteps. Yes, and they say to me, Stanley, is football the greatest game in the world? And I say, yes, footsteps. Yes, it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event.
Ready for this?
spring, they say, a young man's fancy turns to thoughts of love. Right around August, whatever the heck a fancy is starts thinking about football. Because on this hunk of real estate, Carrick and gut still count. And success is measured by 4 zebras and 10 yards of change. Sure, there's more to life than football. But not much. Ow!
Reluctantly crouched at the starting line, engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty, except for one man still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago somebody left with the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance. No flowers, no flashbulbs, no wine. He's haunted by something he cannot define. Bowel-shaking earthquakes of doubt and remorse assail him, impale him with monster truck force. In his mind, he's still thriving, still making the grade. She's hoping in time that her memories will fade. Cause he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and fighting and riding on his horse. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago, somebody left with the cup. But he's striving and driving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. Cause he's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. He's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. He's going the distance.
It's been no bed of roses, no place. What kind of call is that? He's not normally a receiver, is he?
It's probably about his third ball to catch the whole year.
He said it was second.
Second. He caught one big one down Spiral the first ball game, and they left him pretty well open out of that set, and fortunately he made a good catch on that and a good throw.
Was that a running play designed, or is it a passing play?
It's a pass. Yeah. We come back with that after the quarterback sneak. We got a first down, and we felt like that would be there, and it was. Kids deserve a great deal of credit. You know, they just never quit.
They never give up.
Coach, talk about the never quit attitude. You guys have kind of battled back all year long and had a very good season. It ended like this. Like you guys killing yourselves with turnovers and everything.
Well, the first ball game, we didn't make any turnovers. This one we did and put ourselves in a hole, and, kids bounced back and were able to overcome those obstacles. And, that's the mark of a lot of character. And this group at the beginning of the year, I said, had a lot of character, and they showed it. But, with our offense, we didn't, 20, we was down 21 or whatever it was, and, we felt comfortable at halftime. Hey, we didn't panic, and our kids knew what we needed to do that second half, and we did it.
So what did you say from the halftime?
Well, we didn't go in there and holler and scream. We knew what we needed to do. We just needed to stop the turnovers and put the ball in the end zone when we had a chance. We fumbled down there in the third quarter a chance to score. We hurt ourselves the first three periods and about two and a half periods, and then got after it that last quarter and a half.
And to come out quickly in the second half and score a touchdown to kind of give you guys a little.
Yeah, we felt like that first series was the key to the thing, that if we could come out and score that first series, we could set the tone and establish ourselves that second half.
Coach, just go ball and
well, it feels great.
It's one of those deals that you didn't know if you was ever going to get one. I knew my chances probably running out, those I'm getting, it's deserving for this group of kids, because like I said, I thought at the beginning of the year it was a special group, and they showed that.
How about your seniors? They stepped up.
That's one thing we did do at halftime, is challenge those seniors to step up and give us that leadership that they needed. And they did that.
Coach, you feel like a lot of pressure's off your shoulders?
Pressure's mostly self-imposed. It's great to win one, and that's something that you try to do, but at the same time, you try to do some things off the field with kids that are more important than winning the state championship.
So how's it going to feel not having to go to practice on Monday?
Well, it feels great. it's been a long season. If you win a state championship, it is a long season, but then it makes it all worthwhile.
Obviously,
it's
the way you want to kind of continue things on.
Now we'll just go try to defend it next year. So, we'll start work tomorrow getting ready for the Newcastle Racers, because that's who we have, or Monday, because that's who we have, that's who we open up with next year.
All right, Gerard, talk about the last drive a little bit. You guys kind of killed yourself all day long, turnovers. At halftime, what did the coach say to you to get you kind of motivated and get things turned around?
Well, we went into halftime and made some adjustments and came out and executed well. And on that last drive, we told our receivers just to get open, and they made some great catches down the stretch.
How disappointing was it after you guys were driving all the way down the field in the first half and then turned it all over consistently? You guys weren't you were clicking offensively, but then like little mistakes were hurting.
Well, we were disappointed, but, we didn't really get down, and we knew it wasn't over because it's a two-half game, and we knew we could come out second half and just do what they did the first half and dominate the game, and that's what we did.
Second half, you guys got a touchdown early in the second half. How important was that as far as, getting you guys going?
Well, I think when they got up on us, they kind of relaxed, When we scored that first touchdown, kind of woke them up a little, but we was real pumped up and we just dominated the game after that.
How typical of a Spyro Seminole game is this? Is this the way it always is?
Oh yeah, this is the way it always is, against Spyro. They got a good team and we got a good team, and it's always going to come down to the last,
Did you ever have any doubt in the second half?
No, I didn't have no doubt. No doubt at all. We got some hardworking kids on our team and they never gave up, we did a good job.
Touchdown, the last touchdown you guys scored. Maybe they were expecting a run. You guys came with was a play action and.
Brandon Washington. He got open, made a good catch. They were expecting us to run the ball. They sent some linebackers and he went across the middle and made a great catch.
Did you ever think any time during the game that maybe this wasn't your guys' day at all?
Never had any doubt. Never had any doubt. When we was down 28-6, I never had any doubt. I knew we could come back.
As a senior, how's it feel going out with state championship?
Oh, yes. It's the ultimate goal.